Okay, so this time I decided to direct queue for the other two dungeons that I haven't done. So this one is called Atal Dazar, and for dungeons, I think I'm generally going to stay with the following talents: Misery, Last Word, Shadow or Death, Lingering Insanity, and Legacy of the Void. I believe the first two tiers, I will be leaving them at Fortress of the Mind and Body and Soul. So when we pulled this first boss, I'm pretty sure none of us knew what the fuck to do. So it turns out that he occasionally casts a fear, so it would be good to tank him towards the middle of the room. That way you can use the pillars to line of sight very easily without moving too far. But when he pulled it, we were just standing near the stairs. That way, we all got feared, and then I think the tank ran towards the steps, and he pretty much despawns when you run out of the area. I also noticed, but kind of didn't realize entirely at the time, that those purple clouds spawn adds if you run through them, so definitely try not to do that. And occasionally he will target someone and chase you to eat you. I didn't really pay attention to what happens if he gets to someone. I'd imagine it's like a lot of damage. Maybe you can live through it with a damage reduction spell, but I just freaking ran away, so didn't let him get a chunk of me. But this fight is, yeah, generally pretty easy. So I guess as usual, there are a good amount of spells to interrupt in this dungeon, and also, now that we have Psychic Scream back, I do think it is a really good spell to use to interrupt. So what sucks is, yeah, it's 1 minute long without the talent, but every time it's up, I do think it's a good idea to stand next to the mobs, that way you can AoE interrupt. Something I did notice though is I think when some of these trash mobs have some sort of AoE bubble around them where they're channeling something, I do think that my fear just became immune. I wasn't exactly sure which spell was causing it, but I think I did notice that every time they had a bubble due to a channel, it just made interrupts or AoE fears useless. For the second boss, it seems like you kill the reanimation totems located in the triangle formation around the room. And aside from that, you avoid his leaping at you, and he drops void garbage on the floor where you're standing. So on harder difficulties, I can imagine that you would want to stack up to preserve space and then move together as a group.
master gonna build me again.
Protect the priestess! Let no one make you fool!
For the priestess Alunza, I admittedly don't know anything about this fight, so it was pretty much a tank and spank for me, except not to stand in garbage. But according to our healer, you're supposed to soak the bloods, whatever that means. So during the stair portion, I actually didn't know what the hell to do, so for a while it took me a little bit to realize that it's pretty much just like Frogger. So for the last boss, we did end up wiping once because none of us knew what to do. So apparently when he or she, whatever gender it is, Yasma, casts Soul Rend on somebody, it just spawns an ad that walks towards the boss, and when it reaches him, I believe it causes something unpleasant to happen. I did read the dungeon journal, but by now I kind of forget what happens. Something about reaching 100 energy and casting some large damaging spell, I think. So that part is easy, just like run away from the boss as far as you can when you're the target of that spell. And then there's going to be just spider shit that spawns around. So when they are not surrounded by purpley shit, they don't deal damage. But once they are, then if you touch them, they will deal damage. And then I guess there will be a few purple circle garbage on the floor that you just don't want to be standing in. And that is literally the fight.